Good afternoon. Myself Leena Lepande. I am the assistant professor in childhood nursing. Today we will discuss about the topic tracheoesophageal fistula and the esophageal atresia. Before this topic, we will revise the anatomy. So this is the normal esophagus and the trachea. So this is the nose. We will take the air from the nose and the mouth. That air will go in the trachea. Then trachea is continuous with the respiratory system into the lungs. So next, there is the esophagus. It is continuous with the mouth. So this pipe is esophagus. It continues with the stomach. So this is the normal esophagus and trachea. This is the two long tubes, that is the respiratory system and the digestive system. So we will see the next introduction. The tracheoesophageal fistula and the esophageal atresia are the malformation of digestive system in which esophagus does not develop properly. Esophagus does not develop properly. The esophagus is tubes that normally carries food from the mouth to stomach. Next we see the definition. Esophageal atresia. What is meant by atresia? That is the failure to esophagus to continuous passage from the pharynx to the stomach. The digestive system starts from the mouth to stomach. So esophagus is the food pipe. It's continuous with the pharynx to the stomach. So it is the atresia when the failure of esophagus to form continuous passage from the pharynx to the stomach. So this is the atresia, esophageal atresia. Second, tracheoesophageal fistula. The tracheoesophageal fistula is an abnormal connection between the trachea and the esophagus. So, the tracheoesophageal fistula is an abnormal connection between the trachea and the esophagus. Here is the difference. Atresia and the fistula. Here is the this is the failure of the continuous passage. But fistula, there is the abnormal connection between the trachea and the esophagus. So this is the definition of the atresia and the fistula. This is the, see the diagram. There is the failure of the continuous the passage. And this is the fistula, abnormal connection between the esophagus and the trachea. Okay, there is the incidence. The tracheoesophageal fistula occurs in 3,500 births. 1 in 3,500 births with slight male dominance. Esophagus atresia with or without tracheoesophageal fistula is common in prematurity with 34% of cases weighing less than 2,500 grams. It is the more than female in the male. So there is the 1 in 3,500 cases. It is more than female. So it is affected to male babies. Okay. Second is the approximately 50% of neonates with the esophagus atresia or tracheoesophageal fistula have other anomalies also. There is mostly seen in the cardiac anomalies, that is the rate is 14.7 to 28%. So mostly seen in the cardiac anomalies. Ectasia and esophageal ectasia is still unknown. It is the unknown. Then we will see the pathophysiology. Upper part of the esophagus develops from retropharyngeal segment of primitive gut and the lower part from the first part. Then it leads to at 4 to 5 weeks of gestation. Actually, the 4 to 5 of gestation, the esophagus and the trachea was developing. Okay, so that time there are failure to develop. Which gestation? 4 to 5 week gestation. A laryngotracheal groove is formed and divides the forward into the two longitudinal furrows. Then respiratory tract is then separated from the esophagus. Into 4 to 5 week gestation, they are properly developed. When they are not properly developed, so there is the ectasia, otherwise fistula. Okay. So next it leads to the defective separation due to deviated or incomplete septum or due incomplete fusion of tracheal force, result in fistula formation between the trachea and the esophagus. Defective separation due to deviated or incomplete septum. If it is not completed septum, so there is 100% is fistula between the esophagus and the trachea. It due incomplete fusion to tracheal force results in fistula formation between the trachea and the esophagus. So this is the pathophysiology. So there are the five types in the trachea: esophageal ectasia or the fistula. In the first type, here is the five types. In the first type, the esophagus is not continuous. Second is this is the proximal part and distal part. What is the proximal? Upper part, and the distal is the lower part. So the second type is the proximal part is of esophagus. It connects to the trachea, but distal part is the blind pouch. Okay, so in third type, here is the distal part is the connected to the trachea. In fourth type, there is the proximal and distal part is connected to the trachea. And fifth part, it is a continuous part, but it is connected to the trachea. Okay. Here we will see the one by one. The first part, type A. In this type, there is the esophageal ectasia and the proximal and distal segment of esophagus are blind. It means the proximal means it is the upper part, and the distal segment means the lower part. This is the blind pouch. So there is no connection between the trachea and esophagus. This type is present in 3 to 7%. We will see in the diagram. Here is the diagram of this is the proximal part of the esophagus, and this is the distal part of the esophagus. It is the non-continuous. Okay, it is not continuous. So here is the proximal part is the blind and the distal part is the again blind. So here is again the problem. So this is the type A1. So there is no communication between the trachea and the esophagus. So this type is present in 3 to 7% of cases. We will see the second type, that is B. In this type, the esophageal ectasia is present at the blind proximal segment of esophagus connects with the trachea by a fistula. The distal end of esophagus is blind. This type is present in 0.8% of cases. Okay. In second type, the blind proximal part of the esophagus. The upper part is the connect to the trachea. See here. This connect to the trachea. And the distal part is the not connected, it is the blind. Okay? In the first part, there is the proximal and the distal part is the blind pouch in the first type A, and the second type, in this type there is the proximal part is connected to the trachea, so and distal part is the blind. Then type C, in this type esophageal atresia is present. The proximal end of esophagus is blind pouch and the distal segment of esophagus is connected by fissura to the trachea. This is the commonest type present in the most in the babies, that is the 87% of the cases. Okay, here is the proximal part of the esophagus is the blind and the distal part of the esophagus is the connected to the trachea. This is the commonest type in the babies, that is the percentage of the 87%. Okay, already we learn about the type A, there is the blind pouch of the proximal and distal part of the esophagus, that is the blind. In the second part, the proximal part is the connected to the trachea. And the type C, there is the distal part of the esophagus. It is connected to the trachea. Then next, there is the type D. There are the total 5 types, E types. Then this is the type D. It is the rarest type. That occurs in 0.7%. It is the rarest type. In this type, both upper and the lower segments of esophagus communicated with the trachea. So, proximal part of the esophagus and distal part of the esophagus, that are the communicate to the trachea. Here we will see the, this is the proximal part, this is the distal part, they are connected to the trachea. So this is the fissura, the abnormal connection between the esophagus and the trachea. So this is the type, is the rarest type, this is we will see in the 0.7%. The next is the type E. In this type, the esophagus and trachea are normal and completely formed but are connected by a fissura. This type is also known as H type and it is present in the 4.2%. Okay, we will see the diagram. So, this is the continuous pipe of the esophagus and this is the trachea. But in the fissura, it is the connected to the trachea. The esophagus is connected to the trachea. It is a look like a H shape. So it is known as H. Okay. So this is the, you will see in the 4.2% cases. So these are the 5 types. The all 5 types are different. In the first type, there are the blind pouches of the esophagus. In the second type, the proximal part is connected to the trachea. In the third type, the distal part is the connected to the trachea. And the fourth part is the connected upper and the lower. Proximal and distal part are connected to the trachea. And the last part is the connected, it is a continuous pipe, but it is the connected to the trachea. It is looks like H shape. So these are the 5 types. So then next we will see the signs and symptoms. This is the main three C's, that is the choking, coughing and the cyanosis. This is the main three C's signs in the tracheal esophageal fistula. There is the choking, coughing and the cyanosis. What is the cyanosis? Cyanosis means there is the bluish color of the skin of the baby. So next we will see the main, again remaining clinical manifestation. The disorders of is usually detected soon after the birth when feeding is attempted on the basis of falling. First is the violent response occurs on feeding. There is a no slowly response occurs from the feeding. Second is the infant coughs and chokes. We already seen. Then third is the fluid returns through the nose and mouth, that is the regurgitation. When the mother is feeding to the baby, that time the fluid returns from the nose and the mouth. The cyanosis, again it leads to the cyanosis because the baby is not taking properly feed, the baby is not taking oxygen, so they develop the cyanosis. The infant struggles. Second is the excessive secretion coming out of nose and constant drooling of the saliva. Coming out the saliva from the nose and the mouth. The saliva is frothy. What is the frothy? It looks like the foam. Okay. Then abdomen distension occurs in presence of type 3rd, 4th and 5th. There is the abdomen distension. Because of the air goes into the esophagus, there is the abdomen distension. Then 5th, intermittent unexplained cyanosis and the laryngospasm caused by the aspiration of the accumulated saliva in dried esophageal pouch. So there is the unexplained cyanosis. There is the present of the cyanosis and the laryngospasm. There is also spasm. Okay. And it is caused by the aspiration accumulate saliva in blind esophageal pouch. There is the saliva is the accumulate the where is the blind pouch. Okay. Next is the pneumonia may occur due to overflow of the milk and the saliva from the esophagus through fistula into the lungs. There is the pneumonia will occur when the overflow of the milk and the saliva from the esophagus through the fistula into the lungs. Okay, there is the fistula. Fistula it means again there is the connection between the esophagus and the trachea. So there is when the milk goes into the trachea, so there is the pneumonia will present. So next we will see the diagnostic evaluation. How will diagnose this disease? So we will see the first ultrasound examination. It reveals the polyhydramnios, then absence of fluid fill the stomach, then a small abdomen, lower than expected fetal weight. The normal fetal weight is the 2500 to 3.500 kg. So less than the 2.500 baby's weight and a distended esophageal pouch. Then second is the examination, that is the fetal MRI. It may be used to confirm the presence of esophageal atresia and the tracheal esophageal fistula. Okay, we can see the in the EOG report the polyhydramnios, then absence of fluid filled by the stomach. Then a small abdomen, lower than the expected fetal weight and the distended esophageal pouch. And again we will see the diagnostic evaluation. There is the X-ray. X-ray taken with radio opaque catheter placed in the esophagus to check the obstruction. The standard chest X-ray shows that dilated air filled upper esophageal pouch and the can demonstrate pneumonia. Inability to pass NG tube because of the there is the meat resistance. The endotracheal is not goes inside of the stomach because of the there is the blind pouch. Okay, so these made the diagnosis of the esophageal atresia and the tracheoesophageal fistula. Then the bronchoscopy. Bronchoscopy visualize fistula between the trachea and the esophagus. What is the scopy? We can visualize the normal part or abnormal part. Okay, now normal part it means the there is no problem with that part. Okay, abnormal there is the fistula between the trachea and the esophagus. Okay. Then abdominal ultrasound and the echocardiogram to check the for cardiac abnormalities. Because of the if the baby is having the cardiac abnormalities, so in most cases develop to the esophageal atresia and the tracheoesophageal fistula. So abdominal ultrasound is mostly important. Then the treatment. Now there is the treatment. The management of the trachea esophageal fistula is the mainly surgical. Surgical intervention depends on the distance between the distance between the proximal and the distal pouch of the esophagus. Okay, so there is a distance between the proximal and the distal pouch of esophagus. Then type of defect, there are the 5 types, so we can find out the type of defect. Then we will give the treatment of the defect. Then condition of the neonate and his weight. If it is the baby's weight is less than 2500, that is the low birth weight baby, so we will surgery will postpone. Okay. If distance between upper and lower esophageal segment is less than 2.5 cm and if the condition of infant is good, the primary repair is done by division and the ligation of the fistula. So there is the primary repair is the done by the division and the ligation of the fistula. So this is the first stage of primary repair along with the end-to-end anastomosis. Anastomosis means connection. So there is the proximal and distal part, they are the blind, so there is the need of the anastomosis. So anastomosis of the proximal and distal segments of esophagus. So this is the primary repair. Then staging surgery. There are second surgery. There is the 2 stages of the surgery where the distance between the 2 esophageal segments is large, condition of the infant is poor. A 2-stage procedure may be required. If it is the proximal part and the distal part is the more distance is more, so we can surgery in the 2 stages. The first initially there is the first stage, the trachea esophageal fistula is ligated and the gastrostomy done to reduce the risk of reflux, that is the regurgitation, return the food or food on me, okay, anything, okay. There is the gastrostomy done to the reduce the risk of reflux and to the provide feeding. What is the gastrostomy? It is a artificial opening of the stomach, okay. So that is the gastrostomy, okay. The first stage. In the second surgery, there is the 2 stage. In the first stage, the trachea esophageal fistula is ligated. Ligated means to tie, okay, ligated. And the gastrostomy done to reduce the risk of reflux and to provide the feeding. So this is the first stage. And then in the second stage, the both proximal and distal esophageal segments are anastomosis. the both proximal and distal esophageal segments are anastomosed. It means the connection. They are connected to each other. They are connected in the anastomosis procedure to collecting. Okay, if the gap is too large, a segment of colon is used for reconstruction of the esophagus. This is done about the 18 to 24 months. Okay, because in this month the baby will grow. So this the second stage will be done in the 18 to 24 months. Again, I am telling about the treatment. There are the two treatments of the tracheoesophageal fistula and the esophageal atresia. There are the distal part and the proximal part is less than 2.5 centimeter. So there is the primary repair is done by the division and the ligation of the fistula, and it's along with the end-to-end anastomosis of proximal and distal segment of esophagus. And there is the second surgery, there is the two stages. First is the fistula is the ligated. And the gastrostomy done to reduce the risk of reflux. Okay, reflux is the regurgitation of food or milk. And in second stage, the proximal and the distal esophageal segments are anastomosed. If the gap is too large, the segment of colon is used for the reconstruction of the esophagus. This is done about 18 to 24 months. After this surgery, we can go with the nursing diagnosis. There is the nursing diagnosis important for the this condition. Okay, so there are the two nursing diagnosis before the surgery and the after the surgery. We will see the before the surgery preoperative. The risk of aspiration related to structural abnormality. There is the risk for the aspiration because of the they are connected to each other. The esophagus and the trachea, they are connected to each other. So there is the aspiration related to structural abnormality. Then second is the risk for deficient fluid volume related to inability to take oral fluids. There is the inability to take oral fluids. There is the baby will take less volume of the feed. So there is the inability to take oral fluids. Then impaired breathing related to frequent laryngospasm and excessive secretion in the trachea. There is the impaired breathing. It means the not normal breathing pattern. Okay. So baby's respiratory normal rate is the 40 to 60 beats per minute. So there is the normal breath rate. So there is the impaired breathing pattern related to frequent laryngospasm and excessive secretion in the trachea. There is the excessive secretion presence. Okay. So this is the preoperative diagnosis. Then now after the surgery, we will see the diagnosis, that is ineffective airway clearance related to disease process. There is the ineffective airway clearance. Then second is the impaired nutrition related to surgery. Because of surgery done, the baby is not taking properly feed. So there is the impaired nutrition. Then altered comfort related to surgical process. Or the baby is not comfort. So there is the altered comfort related to surgical process. So again, first we will stop the about the nursing diagnosis. Then we will see the nursing intervention. A nasogastric tube is put in the upper esophageal segment and is aspirated frequently to prevent the collection and aspiration of secretion into the trachea. Okay, so there is a nasoangio tube will put in the upper esophageal segment, that is the already surgical, that is the aspirated frequently to prevent the collection and the aspiration of the secretion into the trachea. Intravenous, second is the intravenous fluids are administered to maintain the hydration status of infant. Why we are giving the IV fluids? Because the baby is not taking properly feed. So baby goes in the dehydration. So we will, to maintain the hydration, we will give the intravenous fluids. Then third is the place the infant in semi-upright position and administer the oxygen if cyanosis is present. Okay, baby is having the problem. So baby give the position that is the semi-upright position. Okay. Then a cervical esophagectomy is made to drain out secretion from blind esophageal and blind esophageal pouch and administer oxygen to infant. A cervical esophagectomy will done to drain out the secretion. Again, we have esophagectomy in the artificial opening of the esophagus. So there is the why we have done that surgery, because surgical procedure, that is the to drain out the secretion from the blind esophageal pouch and administer oxygen to the infant. Feed the infant orally or by gastrostomy. Position the baby comfortably in semi-powder position and administer the analgesic. Give the position to the baby, that is the semi-powder position, and the administer the analgesic. Okay. So this is the nursing intervention. Then there is the complication, that is tracheomalacia, weakness of the trachea wall, not developed properly. So there is the weakness. Then anastomostic leak, strictures, dysphagia, and the respiratory distress. Again, the gastroesophageal reflux. These are the complications done in the esophageal fistula and the esophageal atresia. Again, I am telling about the types, because this is the very important types. So this is the five main types. The third type is the commonest types, that is the 87%. Okay, there is the 87% cases. So there is the five types. This is the esophagus is not continuous and the trachea is there. So there is the two part, upper proximal and distal. It is not continuous. Second is there is the blind pouch, but proximal part is connected to the trachea. The third type is, that is the distal part is connected to the trachea and proximal part is the blind. In the four types, there is the proximal and distal part of the esophagus, that is the connected to the trachea. And the fifth part, it is the continuous, but it is the also connected to the trachea. So third type is the most common. So again, I am telling about the definition. It is a very, very important. So there is what is the esophageal atresia? Esophageal atresia is the failure of esophagus. Esophagus is the food pipe. It starts from the mouth to stomach. Okay, so this is the failure of esophagus to form a continuous passage from the pharynx to stomach. Ataxia is the failure to continuous passage from the mouth, pharynx to the stomach. And fissura, it means the abnormal opening, connection or the opening between the trachea and the esophagus. Okay. So we will see in the diagram. This is the diagram. This is the blind. Okay. Trachea and the esophagus. There is the three main signs of the this condition. There is a three C's. Please remember, this is the three C's, that is the choking, coughing and the cyanosis. Three C's. This is the very important because the baby is unable to take breath. So there is the choking because of the choking. So baby also coughing and the baby is not taking properly oxygen. So there is the cyanosis present. Diagnostic evaluation is very important because this baby is not taking feed properly after the soon after the birth, so we can examine the ultrasound. Again, there is the fetal MRI, then X-ray, and inability to pass the NG because of the there is the obstruction because of the esophagus is the blind pouch. There is the bronchoscopy is also important, and abdominal ultrasound and the echocardiogram. There is the treatment, there is the surgery, there is the main two surgery. In the first surgery, there is the primary repair of the ligation of the fistula, and the second surgery there is the proximal and the distal part is the less than 2.5 centimeter. So there is the will the fistula ligated and gastrostomy is done to reduce the risk of reflex. And if there is the distance is too large, the second stage will do the both proximal and distal esophageal segments and anastomosis. If the gap is too large, segment of colon is used for reconstruction of the esophagus. The baby's age that time, the baby's age will 18 to 24 months. It means the 1.5 year to 2 years that time we will do the surgery. There is the nursing diagram before the surgery and after the surgery. Okay, so I revise my all topics. Thank you, everyone.